We're at the second intermission. Saturday Headlines is presented by Huawei Smartphones. Nick, Chris Johnston and Elliot now. And Nick, there's a meeting planned.
Well, Ron, we can start the show off by telling you that the Consumer Electronics Show is going to be held in Vegas this week at the Convention Center. Why is that important? Because it attracts pro leagues and unions. And yes, Ron, it includes the National Hockey League and the Players Association. So we can assume, besides talking gadgets, they will be talking CBA and the potential of a World Cup in 2020. Now, I'm starting to hear, perhaps within the next 2 weeks, that the NHL Players Association could even table an offer to Gary Bettman and the owners to extend the CBA. And of course, the players know at this point that there's a lot of things that they won't get back, but they do have a wish list, and one of those things on the wish list is to alleviate some of the financial burden of escrow. And I'm not sure where they're going to go with that, whether it is a non-starter or there's wiggle room, but at least they're talking, and that's a good thing.
I saw Alex Ovechkin deciding not to go to the All-Star as, well, we didn't get to go to the Olympics, I'm not going to your All-Star. You buy that?
Some people wondered that. I mean, you know, obviously he's made his said that he's doing it for rest, but the question did not go unthought upon in NHL circles, I can tell you that. But I do think that's something that's going to come up as part of these conversations, too. There was talk this week about the NHL maybe increasing the amount of games you have to sit out. I don't think the league actually wants to do that. I don't think they want to go there. But I do think there will be conversations during this process about, hey, if you go to a certain amount of games, can you beg out of one?
Where the Olympics sort of enters the picture is Beijing, Chris.
Yes, and some very interesting comments today out of Vancouver from Rene Fasel, who runs the IIHF, in saying that he wants to see more small ice hockey played internationally. That includes at the 2022 World Cup of World Championship, rather, in Finland, but also the 2022 Beijing Olympics. I'm having trouble with this one. But what's important here that is that some people believe this is a bit of an olive branch that's been extended to the NHL, to the NHL players, to try to entice them to come back to Beijing, because obviously that's something the league favors. The previous games in Nagano, in Turin, and in Sochi, the overseas Olympics with NHL players, all had the bigger ice. The smaller ice is what the players over here are used to.
Speaking of Vancouver,
Quinn Hughes is playing very well for Team USA at the World Juniors, and he's a Vancouver Canucks pick. The team is an organization, fans are very excited about him. There was some internal discussion by the Vancouver Canucks with his team, Michigan, having a very rough season in the NCAA. Do we ask him if, after the World Juniors, does he want to join the Canucks now and turn pro? They had the decision internally, discussion internally. They decided not to do it. They said, we made a deal, and that was we talked to him after the season. So even though they discussed it, Nick, they decided not to approach the player and tempt him in any way.
Elliot, from the youth on the blue line to the experience on the blue line for the Vancouver Canucks, we can expect in the next couple of weeks the Canucks to start talking about a contract extension for Alex Edler. Now, of course, Edler's made it real clear he's got a complete no trade. And even if the Canucks weren't interested, Ron, in signing him at the end of the season, he still didn't want to get traded. But the good news now is he's probably playing the best hockey in the last few years, and they will sit down and start discussing what it would take to get him on a deal. He's already at $5 million per season. There is a chance he could actually improve that on an AAV, but I think it would have to be run on a short-term deal.
All right, Ottawa.
Well, the clock ticks towards February 25th, an NHL trade deadline. And as it does so, it's quite interesting that the talks between the Ottawa Senators and Matt Duchene, their pending unrestricted free agent, appear to have cooled off. There doesn't seem to have been anything of substance here in recent times. No talks immediately scheduled in the weeks ahead. And why this is interesting is because Ottawa has struggled, having lost seven straight. Pierre Dorion, the general manager, obviously doesn't want to place any sort of deadline on when he needs an answer on Matt Duchene's intentions, whether he will sign an extension, but clearly, as this slides along here, guys, we are looking at him as a potential target in that trade deadline period, and someone that the Senators are going to have to make a decision on. I don't get the sense from Duchene's side that there's any rush for them to make that kind of decision.
Another team that has said that we cannot be in a position to let our unrestricted free agents walk for nothing is Carolina, and I believe that's why a lot of talks have heated up on Michael Ferland. I don't think they're anywhere close between the team and the player. Carolina has two unrestricted free agent goalies, Mrazek and McElhinney. It don't think they're prepared to do anything yet. They need someone to play. But another name, guys, I'm curious about is Dougie Hamilton. They have four right shot Ds. They've been asked about Hamilton. If you're willing to come back at them with a score, I think that they would be considered doing it.
It's amazing how players coming out of Carolina suddenly do well. Elias Lindholm in Calgary, even Noah Hanifin is scoring like crazy. Jeff Skinner, Eric Staal, we thought was all washed up. He's great. And two coaches at the All-Star Game are former Hurricanes head coaches. Paul Maurice is one of them. Bill Peters, of course, the other. And bad news for Paul.
Yes, bad news for Paul and the Winnipeg Jets. Another week, another significant injury here to Nikolaj Ehlers. Took this hit on his first shift against Sidney Crosby in Friday's game. They've said that he won't be back before mid-February. So following the news of Dustin Byfuglien last week, the Jets are dealing with a couple big losses.
Right. Okay, Tara Sloan, you'll be in the next block. Don't worry. Kraft Hockeyville, the nominations are underway now for Kraft Hockeyville 2019. You can support your team. You can nominate your team by going to krafthockeyville.ca. And just to remember how great it is, here's the center of the universe in hockey last September, Lucan.
There are not many communities that can say that they are Kraft Hockeyville. We're a small group and we're a proud group. Lucan is a small rural town in southwestern Ontario. The arena really is the hub of our community.
With the $250,000 we won from Kraft Hockeyville, we were able to get a brand new dasherboard system, 6 foot tall glass, LED scoreboard, and a brand new sound system. Kids are really excited to know that NHL players are going to be changing the same change rooms that they change in, play on the same ice that they play on, and they can know that forever this was their rink.
I think Kraft Hockeyville is a great event for small towns across the country, and I think it gets you back to your roots.
How you doing? How's things at Lucan?
There will be lasting effect in this community. Great things happen when you have a common goal, and of course that is the love of hockey.